Good morning. Good morning and happy birthday, America. The 4th of July is my favorite non-religious holiday. Who doesn't love to eat barbecue and blow things up? I have the great good pleasure of leading you in morning prayer today. So let us begin. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us kneel and confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. O Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall show forth your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving.
And we raise a loud shout to him with songs.
For the Lord is a great God.
And a great King above all gods.
In his hand are the caverns of the earth.
And the heights of the hills are his also.
The sea is his, for he made it. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee.
And kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand.
Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
The mercy of the Lord is everlasting.
Come, let us adore him.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. All the tribes of Israel came to David at Hebron and said, "Look, we are your bone and your flesh. For some time while Saul was king over us, it was you who led out Israel and brought it in. The Lord said to you, 'It is you who shall be shepherd of my people Israel, you who shall be ruler over Israel.' So all the elders of Israel came to the king at Hebron, and King David made a covenant with them at Hebron before the Lord. and they anointed David king over Israel. David was 30 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 40 years. At Hebron, he reigned over Judah 7 years and 6 months. And at Jerusalem, he reigned over all Israel and Judah 33 years. David occupied the stronghold and named it the City of David. David built the city all around from the Milo inwards, and David became greater and greater, for the Lord, the God of hosts, was with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 48 responsively by half verse. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised.
In the city of our God is his holy hill.
Beautiful and lofty, the joy of all the earth is the hill of Zion.
The very center of the world and the city of the great king.
God is in her citadels.
He is known to be.
Behold, the kings of the earth assembled.
And marched forward together.
They looked and were astounded.
They retreated and fled in terror.
Trembling seized them there.
They writhed like a woman in childbirth, like ships in the sea when the east wind shatters them.
As we have heard, so have we seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God.
God has established her.
We have waited in silence on your loving kindness, O God.
In the midst of your temple.
Your praise, like your name, O God, reaches to the world's end.
Your right hand is full of justice.
Let Mount Zion be glad and the cities of Judah rejoice.
Because of your judgments.
Make the circuit of Zion, walk round about her.
Count the number of her towers.
Consider well her bulwarks, examine her strongholds.
That you may tell those who come after.
This God is our God forever and ever.
He shall be our guide forevermore.
A reading from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. I know a person in Christ who was 14 years old who was caught up into the third heaven. Whether in body or out of body, I do not know. God knows. And I know that such a person, whether in the body or out of the body, God knows, was caught up into paradise and heard things that are not to be told, that no mortal is permitted to repeat. On behalf of such a one, I will boast. But on my own behalf, I will not boast, except of my weaknesses. But if I wish to boast, I will not be a fool, for I will be speaking the truth. But I refrain from it so that no one may think better of me than what is seen in me or heard from me, even considering the exceptional character of the revelations. Therefore, to keep me from being too elated, a thorn was given to me in the flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me, to keep me from being too elated. 3 times I appealed to the Lord about this, that it would leave me, but he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ, for whenever I am weak, then I am strong. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus came to his hometown and his disciples followed him. On the Sabbath he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astounded. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been given to him? What deeds of power are being done by his hands? Is it not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, and brother of James, and Joseph, and Judas, and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Then Jesus said to them, "Prophets are not without honor, except in their hometown, and among their own kin, and in their own house." And he could do no deed of power there, except that he laid his hands on a few sick people and cured them. And he was amazed at their unbelief. Then he went about among the villages teaching. He called the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over the unclean spirits. He ordered them to take nothing from their journey except a staff, no bread, no bag, no money in their belts, but to wear sandals and not to put on two tunics. He said to them, whenever you enter a house, stay there until you leave the place. If any place will not welcome you and they refuse to hear you, as you leave, shake off the dust that is on your feet as a testimony against them. So they went out and proclaimed that all should repent. They cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. Grace, mercy, and peace be unto all of us from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated. A sermon for morning prayer is optional, so I don't have a sermon for you today. Yay, right? But our second lesson, where Paul talks about his weaknesses, inspired me to share something with you that I have been experiencing here at Grace over the last couple of weeks. Now, last week I told you that Andy, the owner of the housekeeping service, said that he would continue to clean the chapel at no cost to us for as long as we needed because he wants to do something to help us. After the service, I had three members come up to me individually and say, "Call me when you're going to do that. I want to come and help." And then I had another member come up to me and say that she and two other ladies wanted to start the card writing program again, where they send out cards to members who've been absent for a while. They invite them back to Grace, recognize newcomers and visitors just to stay in touch. And then yet another member came up and told me that he was volunteering both his time and his expertise to a very important committee because he felt called to do so. And he said to me, "I will do everything I possibly can to help this church and to keep it going." And Paul, in his letter, talked about his sufferings and his struggles and how he prayed to God to relieve them. Grace Church is experiencing some hardships. We are struggling to overcome our weaknesses. But it is in this struggle that I see us coming together. We will continue to pray for wisdom, for guidance through this time. But as the Lord told Paul, "My grace is sufficient for you, and for power is made perfect in weakness." We are Grace, and together we are very strong. Can we all get an amen? Amen. Amen. Now let us stand and recite the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate.
was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And now, as our Savior has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving help among all the nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. O God, you made us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, and that the week to come may be spent in your favor. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life, we may not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry, they may truly and devoutly serve you. Through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
You may be seated.
The prayers of the people. Bound together in Christ in the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us pray with one heart and mind to God our Father. We pray for peace from things that separate us from one another, and we pray for our salvation.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, especially
Good Shepherd Sepulpa,
Institute for Anglican Theology, Montevideo, Uruguay, the Diocese of Montana, and the Episcopal Church in the Philippines. We pray for this holy gathering and those who enter with faith, reverence, and fear of God.
Lord have mercy.
We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Paulson, our bishop, Tom, our clergy, Tim and Pat, our wardens, vestry, delegates, all who minister in Christ, and for all the holy people of God. Lord have mercy. We pray for the world and its leaders, our nation and its people. We pray for our leaders, especially Joe, our president, Kamala, our vice president, Mark Wayne, our congressman, James and Jim, our senators, Kevin, our governor, and Marlon, our mayor. Lord have mercy. We pray for prisoners, the oppressed, and all those in need or suffering, especially Barbara and family, the Blackwell family, Brad, the Brewer family, James and Shirley, Judy, Sherry, B, Ethan, Linda, John, Angie, Brian, Glenn, Dante, Marilyn, Gary, Ann, Connie, Cliff, Esther, Ann, Ronald, Michael, Sheila, Marley, Carl, Geneva, the Stewart family, the Daniels family, the Sailor family, Robert, all emergency responders, United States military, and those whose suffering is known only to God. We pray for those who have died, especially those who have perished in the tragedy in Florida. Lord, have mercy. We pray for ourselves, our families, and those we love. We pray for those in our parish, especially John, Melody, James, and Kim. And also for those who are traveling, especially David Edwards. Lord, have mercy. Remembering our most blessed Mary and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Christ.
To you, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray, not as we ask in our ignorance, nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you. Greet one another in the name of Christ.
Peace to you.
Peace to you.
Bright pink highlights.
Yeah, well, I
why not?
Maybe it comes down blue.
Okay.
Ken, what am I supposed to tell?
America the Beautiful.
We're not doing the
insert.
BJ, what announcements do you have?
Just that Ken asked me to please tell you that we are not, we won't be doing the insert. So that's. It's nice to have it in there, though.
Okay.
The Cubs are here today, the Cubs and the troop. We have members of our Cub Scout pack and members of our new Boy Scout troop are here to help with the flags today, and we're glad to have them.
Wonderful.
They worked hard at the fundraiser yesterday at the farmer's market. We did very well. We are doing a spice fundraiser, and there will be more information on that soon.
Okay. I have just a couple of quick announcements. This coming Friday at noon is going to be our first semi-monthly gather together and clean the church. There will be a text going out to the Altar Guild members, but anyone else who would like to come and pitch in, I'm thinking within an hour, we'll get the Swiffer team going and we will, no cobweb will be safe, no speck of dust, no bit of lint, they'll all be gone. The second thing is also this Friday at 2 o'clock, the Grace Quilters are starting back up meeting again. So come learn to stitch if you don't know how, trust me. You'll be with the silliest group of sewers that you've ever seen. And I had one more. Nancy is looking for at least two more people to learn how to run the videographer so that she can take a break at some point. Trust me, you will love to be back there. It's like a cockpit.
It is.
There's so many wonderful buttons and knobs. She won't let me play with it, but hey, that is what it is. And then I believe...
Yeah.
Go ahead, Tim.
Yeah.
I just have one more.
Okay.
Just a reminder that next Sunday we're having the Father Bob Wickheiser's Appreciation Day. So that's, I think, flashing up there as well. But it's at the Papillion, and it's 4 to 7 p.m.
So, all are invited.
Yes.
Also, next Saturday, rats, and I'm not sure of the time. I'm going to have to look. The Muskogee Quester Group, which meets here at Grace, is sponsoring a tea to raise money for the Ellis Robertson home. And I will do an all call, and I'll put... emails out on it also. And I believe it is from 2 to 4 here at Grace in the parish hall. It'll be like a formal tea, and there's no charge for the event itself, but donations for the home are requested. Please come.
So as your senior warden, I wanted to update you on our current financial state. So as you remember, back in late April, Chad Wetz and I sent a letter out to the members of Grace Episcopal Church. Last year, we had a deficit budget, which grew to an unprecedented $163,000 during the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic. This year, our anticipated budget deficit is $170,000, so it's an even larger amount this year than last year. And that's due to a number of reasons, but part of it's lower weekly donations and also lower weekly attendance. So understandably, Bishop Paulson Reed and Canon Eric Cooter have challenged this church's leadership to improve our financial situation before we can call an interim pastor and also start the search process for this church's next rector. In the past 2 months, however, through Father Bob's leadership, your vestry's leadership, and the incredible church staff that we have, Nancy included, but also Carol and Ken, we have raised our income by $33,000 over budget and decreased our expenses by $16,000, which is a $49,000 reduction in our deficit. Plus, through new pledges and a one-time gift, our deficit budget right now is down to $105,000, which is amazing. So I know the canons, Canon Eric and Canon Will, were really impressed with that when we discussed that last week. So through recent conversations with Canon Eric and Canon Will, if we can get our anticipated deficit down to somewhere between 10% to 16% of our operating budget, which translates to about $30,000 to $50,000, then we can start the search process for a new rector and also call an interim pastor. This past week, a church member who wishes to remain anonymous has talked to me about how to narrow our current deficit down to that which will allow us to start the search process. This church member has pledged up to $25,000 as a challenge grant. So this church member will match dollar for dollar all new giving to our church up to $25,000 to help overcome this remaining budget shortfall. So as a church, when we raise an additional $30,000 with the pledge to match of $25,000, that will bring us to $55,000, which will lower our deficit of $105,000 down to $50,000, which is the upper limits of where the diocese wants us to be so we can actually start the search process for a new rector. So I think that's very doable. And when you start thinking about what $30,000 means, you know, it's a lot of money, but we have an average church attendance of around 50 people, an average of 105 views online every Sunday. So if there are 150 people that could then give $200 to our church as a one-time gift, we will raise this $30,000. So it's very doable. So again, 50 people at church, 105 views online, that's about 150 people. So if each person gives $200 as a one-time gift, we can raise that $30,000, have the matching gift of $25,000, and that will narrow our deficit down to just $50,000. And at that point, then we can start asking the diocese for help in searching for a new rector and also calling an interim pastor. So it's very doable. So I just challenge you to think about that, to pray for it, pray about it, and hopefully we can make this deficit go away very soon. Thank you.
Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries? I didn't think so, considering the crowd that we had last week. If you remember that, there were like nine people up here? Absolutely. All right, then. Thanksgiving on page 6. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all of you. Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves for your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us. granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.